Domination Nation, what up? It's me, you, back on Dominations. Thank you so much for joining me here on the Doom Raider channel. The channel is thriving, over 900 subscribers, the videos getting hella views, and it's all thanks to you, me, Dominations. Anyways, enough of that. It's been a while, about a month like always. I try to get more videos out, but it just doesn't work out sometimes. So, what I do is I put more content in the videos. You can skip ahead. Down in the description, I'll put timestamps. Sometimes these videos get a little long, a little strong. They are down to get the friction on, so just skip ahead to whatever parts you want to see. We'll talk about the Rush event, my recent upgrades that I've been doing, the 6.1 update notes, the saliva buildup in the corner. I'll put a time... No, I won't. And also, three layouts. We've got three layouts. This biblio. So, first things first, let's get down to business. My videos. I took out the FC and I put in the Coliseum. Forbidden City is no more. I'm feeling like the further up you go, Atomic Age and Cold War Age, obviously, Forbidden City is just not quite as valuable. I don't even consider it a factor when I attack my war attacks, when I make my war attacks right now. I just go right in and I blast right through somebody, typically hitting the city center along the way to my 50% destruction, because it's about 11% of the total hit points on a base anyway. So I did drop that. That's one of the first things you'll notice. And also upgraded my walls during the recent event, the Rush event, what was it, Winter for the Ages. Took all my walls up to level 12, and a few of them, about 20 extra up to level 15. So pretty stoked about that. Also hammered out all the maxed gates that there are, all the yellow 15 gates. And you can take a look at the specs with the Max Saladin research on them. That's wall gate hit points. Level 15 gate has 33.6K. Level 12 wall, 31.2 with the Max Saladin. And level 15, as far as Atomic, that's max hit points you can get on a wall. 49K. Very nice. With the recent event, the Rush event, I kind of abandoned my strategy of getting all the XP I could. I was going for just traps and library back to back. I still am doing library, but I abandoned my traps to do the buildings, the oil buildings specifically, because they were half off, and I hate looting for oil. It's a pain in my assholes. And so I was able to take my bunkers from level 2 to level 3 and 1 to level 4, which just finished a moment ago. Airstrip up to level 4, and I took my airplanes to MK2. So that's nice. Pardon me. Let's see. So anytime there's a discount event, I go for the oil stuff. You can do it your own way. I just hate looting for oil because it just takes forever. And even as French, I can just go right in and bowl people over with my tanks. But it just gets boring. So that's what I did. The next thing on the radar let's talk about is the current event, the Carnival do Brasil. I'm not sure if that's how you pronounce it in Portuguese, but that's how we say it in American idiot. Carnival do Brasil event. 33% cheaper upgrades to all troops, generals, and tactics, as well as 50% faster troop training time. So for me, getting into this, I got to start some stuff. I basically need to do some oil looting right away to take advantage of these. I have two upgrades that just finished. My airplane went up to MK2. And my factory bazooka, I finally got veteran bazooka. I still don't use the troop. I probably only trained 5 bazookas in my life. But I'm getting it up to elite bazooka with this discount. And I'll probably take my airplane up to MK4 since the event lasts 10 days or 9 days, not sure. But that's time for me to do this one and one more airplane research. A lot of people are going to say do your generals, which is probably a smart idea, because a lot of generals, if they're under level 20, they only take 2 days. And if you've got 2 research spots, you could do effectively 10 researches at 33% off. And that's a lot of oil that you could save there as well. I just like to save on the super high expensive oil, like the 200,000 oil items. And so that's what I'm going for with this event. Also with the 50% faster training time and the 60% 66% or whatever it is on the blessing, and my 20% boost of French altogether. That's like a 1,000% faster training time. I don't have to train troops right now. They just train themselves. In fact, yeah. Stupid joke. Anyways. Moving right along, though. What's next on the agenda? We're going to get to the three base layouts here in just a second. 6.1 notes. So three different traps came out. Two of them are atomic, or two of them are Cold War Age only. The Signal Flare and... what is it here? What's this one called? The Claymore. So this one has a directional charge, which does conical damage, if you will. Now, I'll start with the Claymore. Basically, what it is it's got a damage range of 5, which is more than the range on your landmine, which I think is 3. Let me take a peek here. Range of 1. Okay, even less. So the point is, with the Claymores, it has a longer range damage, but it does it in a directional damage. So it really doesn't matter to me. I mean, your troops are coming in from one side. Rarely are they all, is your, you know, your damage going to be around the whole trap. So it's pretty cool. It's a good defensive upgrade. Does a little bit of damage. Probably needs to be upgraded a little bit more. Also, going to notice the Signal Flare. This one's pretty sweet. Now, this one needs to be, in my opinion, used near your bunkers. What it does is it instantly spawns a bonus wave of temporarily boosted defenders from nearby garrison stables and bunkers. Range of 3. I don't have a lot of information on this, as I am a atomic. I haven't been able to test it much. I did kind of play around with some alliance challenges, but in my experience, just reading this, range of 3 means that it can... it's only going to... it either is triggered within a range of 3, or it... does the spawning boost in a range of 3, which isn't very much, so I'm not quite sure on that. Please clear me up in the comments if you could. But the point is, if you're going to use the Signal Flare, probably be best to put it near your bunkers. The more heavy tanks on the battlefield, the better. Right, guys? Right, guys? And there's a bunch of other junk there you can look at when you go CWA. Something else that you can get in starting the atomic is the decoy trap. Now, this needs to be used very specific way for it to be effective. In multiplayer, put it on the side of your refinery where it's going to be attacked from most frequently. I did have my refinery here and my traps on the left side. I don't know why I did it that way, but I moved it over because typically attacks are coming in, at least from my experience, from the Alliance gate or from the embassy side. Less people want to go over Versailles or the silo area, or the city center. If they're coming right at my oil refinery, at least that's what I'm trying to prove here. The point of having the decoy trap there is because it totally takes over a rally. No other trap or item in your defensive array does this. And what I mean by that is, well, let's just quickly watch a replay here. There it is. Okay, 14 ARL, maxed ARL tanks, max health and damage in the university. I'm just sending them all in from right here, trying to get to my refinery. And the point of showing this is, for one, this base, this defense, this multiplayer base I have is just nasty. Even maxed ARLs can't quite get their way. Now, I don't go tactics. I don't use any decoys or whatever. That's for losers that can't get oil without tactics. I don't like to spend any resources at all. I want to minimize the resources required so that I can maximize the loot gain. Anyways, they're coming in on this, and they're rallied on that oil refinery. Nothing should stop them, but the decoy trap totally takes them off their rally, and they don't get a single hit on my refinery because they have to, because the decoy trap changed their focus to that trap, and they get nothing. Zero oil gained, and that's the point. I don't know if that's clear, if everybody quite understands the importance of that. So in multiplayer, that decoy trap, if it's going to be used at all, put it on the side of your oil refinery where everybody's coming in on, and it's going to be maximized. At the very least, it's going to require them to have to do a second rally to hit that, refinery, unless, of course, they're coming in with... raiders, in which case once they destroy the decoy trap, or once it expires, then they'll refocus on the next closest loot item, which would be the oil. And so they don't have to be, but there's no way anybody's getting through here with raiders and wall sappers unless they're magical. At least in my experience. You could take a look at my defense log here. And I can scroll through every single one of these. Not a single one got to my refinery. You can see some higher. Look, that's just pegging my wells when I hadn't claimed off of them in a while. Same thing with that one. They did not get to my refinery at all. Anyways, so if you're looking for some way of protecting your oil, you know, here it is, folks. But anyways, I say that to say this, that decoy trap's pretty sweet. I like it a lot. A lot of people on the forums are whining. Big shocker. That's all they do there. They're like, why do the defensive? Nobody needs more defense. Yes, they do. People, you can't. 5-star is the normal in war now, and not even that. 2 minutes is slow. If 2 minutes is slow to get a 5-star, something's wrong with the game. Really, in my opinion, there shouldn't be all 5-star bases in war. It should be a lot harder on defense, a lot harder. And so these traps are just kind of getting us there. Same thing with the silo. If we're talking about a balanced game, I mean, if you want it to be easy to get a 5-star, then yeah, maybe less defensive things, but it doesn't really make any sense, you know. But I'm not going to try to convince anybody of that, because some people just no understandy. They no understandy me talky. But moving right along, that's the new traps from the 6.1 update. They've also added a couple adjustments to the expeditions and an extra shipyard. It's a big shocker. There's a lot of whining on the forums for that. And I'm sorry if you're one of the people that complain on the forums, but I ain't got time for that. And you're wasting your time anyways, because you're wrong. That's it for the 6.1 notes. Talked about the current sale, my strat going forward. I'm trying to get to 220, but I'm also going to be taking advantage of these sales as they come up. And, you know, here's where I'm at. I'll be CWA. I'll be showing some more CWA videos when I get there, but there's not a whole lot of changes. More like Atomic 2.0 when you get to Cold War Age. So a lot of these base layouts and stuff I'm doing now will still apply for you folks in CWA. So getting to that, let's talk layouts. Here's this one we've already seen, what it can do for you in multiplayer, and heck, it'd probably be a good war base too. I haven't run it as a war base yet, but you've probably seen this layout online tons of times. Let's talk war bases. And this one is the least exciting as far as the least change, you know, over what you may have already seen out there. This is the this is my version of the 5-box. And, you know, 5-box, you can see 1-box, 2-box, 3-box, 4x5-boxes there. That's why I would call it that. One centralized box. Now, the traditional setup does not have trap paths built in here. When I say trap paths, I mean places where troops are going to be likely to pass through and run over traps, because that's where the openings in the walls are. And got some lunch stuck in there. It's still good. It's still tasty. Anyways, so I opened up the block, opened up the corners on this 5-block base, and I put the traps in there. I placed the mortars where they can reach both trap paths, both corners, right here. Right here, the mortar reaches. What that does is mortar overlappage. So any troops coming through, running over all those barbed wires and doodads, they're gonna be double duty on the mortar. I've also got the anti-tank in range of the trap path. So as they're snaking around the path, slowly as possible, under readout suppression, they're also being hit by anti-tank guns. And this is the same pattern repeated over and over. Mortar, anti-tank, readout. Mortar, anti-tank, readout. And we've also got towers on the corners, resources on the outside. And if you don't agree with this specific layout, where everything is, you can change it around. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to pause the video, and I'll come back, and everything will be erased. And you can see the layout in more detail as far as the roads, the build, the walls, and the trap placement. So hang in here with me. Okay, so here it is. This is a stripped down version just to make it easier for copying. I recommend pausing the video or taking a screenshot, and then you can go back and forth between, you know, layout editor and this as an example. And that's the easiest way I can think of. Obviously, you want to centralize everything before you start building it all. or you can just do the walls and then adjust it to make sure it fits in the middle of whatever deforested pattern you have. I am making a little adjustment with the SAM batteries. They've basically been, what's happening is if you put them too close together, they'll all hit one plane, and instead of hitting two different planes or three different or four different planes, where they can kind of be a little bit more effective. In my opinion, that's the way I want it. I had them all grouped together there, but changing that. Put my decoy trap right here in the middle, kind of near my silo and my city center. You know, I'm thinking that if there's going to be any rallies at some point in this attack on my base, that it's going to be near the middle of the base somewhere, most likely on the city center or the silo. And so what better way to destroy a rally than with a nicely placed decoy trap? And that's what I think it's best used for. So let's go ahead and cancel, hit OK, take one last look. Centralized stronghold, so you've got your four mortars there, stronghold in the middle, fort, silo, all kinds of heavy stuff in the middle there. And I think this is a really great design. It's just an update on the five box layout. So that's that one. Now let's move on to another warbase. Let's talk about base number two for this video. Warbase is right here. This one here I call the Radar Research Base. And the reason for that, if you've done the radar research in the library, you get a 15% boost on towers, readouts, mortars, anti-tanks, and air defense. And the only way to get that boost is if they're touching your road network and your road network is touching your city center. I'm sure everybody hopefully knows that by now, but you never know. So once you've done that, the way to maximize that is to get every building on that network. And this is one of the, you know, that was one of the ideas I had in mind when I set this base up. I also had some ideas when it came to funneling troops towards my stronghold, also towards my city center and my silo. And so basically, this one was designed with the Forbidden City before I swapped to the Colosseum, which I just recently did. So you can imagine the Forbidden City being here. This base setup will still work with Colosseum as opposed to Forbidden City. In fact, I'd probably move Acropolis there and, you know, put the old Colosseum there instead. But that's beside the point. What this base centralized, and I had an event building there that's gone. We can always adjust some stuff for that. But the point of this base is it's got the 5.5 spacing on the mortars, so you can't get to the mortars without going around the walls or through the walls. If you come in through the sides, you're going to trip the factory spawnage of the heavy tanks. And if you come in towards the city center, you got to deal with Versailles, city center troops, stronghold troops, all that good stuff on the way to the missile silo. And another benefit of this kind of centralized three box setup, you see how there's three rectangles in this central box there, is if somebody comes in from the sides and they're going to try to rally on the silo, which happens a lot in war attacks, their troops are not going to come through this sidewall where they have to go through two walls to get to the silo. They're going to route themselves all the way up and around and right up here and try to come down through the top where it's just one wall separating them from the silo, and that's their goal. So the point is there's three anti-tank guns, stronghold, city center, traps galore, all waiting for them when their troops finally do get up there and come in this way. That's a perfect no, but I'm always working on different ideas. I've run this base. It has been successful in wars, defended already. I never stick really with one base because I just love to do the layout thing. That's my deal. I get bored playing the game, so I want to do even more. This is one of those layouts that may work for you. Let me strip it down and show you the bases of it. Pause this, skip this. You'll pick up right where we left off here. Okay, so with everything stripped out, you can kind of get a better feel for the road network and the design, you know, the ideas that went in with it. There it is. All you gotta do is pause the video, copy it, screenshot it, and then, you know, go back and forth between the layout editor and your photo or the paused video, and you can create the same base. All my bases are centralized in the deforested area that I have. I've got a 6x7 deforested area with two little bonuses on this side. So it's kind of rectangular, and that's why it's turned in this direction. If you have a different shape deforested base, you'll have to turn it a little bit. That's why I recommend doing the walls and the roads first, so you can see if it fits and if you need to turn things before you spend the whole time trying to create the layout and then realizing you have to change it all. So there's that one. That is the radar research layout. Here we go. Let's get started though. This base has got 5 outside sections. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 enclosed areas. Kind of encompassing a centrally located section and then a Versailles section that's not enclosed with walls. And so I thought it was pretty sweet. This is a non-FC, a non-Forbidden City base design. Doesn't quite utilize Acropolis or Colosseum as much as some people would prefer. But, you know, I'm playing around with different designs to see what I think works better, what doesn't. And this is one that I want to share with you. So let's take a look. It's got the 5 spacing on the mortars again, so you got to do that. I do that every layout. I think it's basically a fundamental piece that everyone should have in their designs. Maybe not as important as I think it is. I don't know. I think it's important. I'll also try to get as many buildings on the network to get the 15% boost out of the radar research that I've done. And I pretty much have everything on the network here in this one as well. And okay. There she be. LNGs. Ladies and gents, this is the base. Stripped down in its rawest form. You can see the different compartments, the crescent shape. And, you know, it's a great base. I really only ran this for 1 or 2 wars. Got wrecked by some super high CWA guy. And I really couldn't tell you if it was any good. Pretty sweet base in my opinion. So it does involve a little trap pathing down here. Now you can change that up. You don't have to keep it like this. But, you know, I have a bunch of readouts down there. And the fort, where's my generals, on the way to the silo location, which is right there. And I'll cancel this one instead of saving it. We can kind of take a look at it a little bit closer. There it is. I mean, that's it. Not that much to say because I'm tired of talking about bases right now. And you don't really see it on the video because I've edited out the troubles that I've been having with it, but I'm gonna have to get a new screen share. Probably gonna have to download AirPlay or buy that stupid program so I don't have to keep dealing with the freezing, as it's already froze right here again. And so that's it for this video. Join San Fran Tokyo, the sickest alliance, the greatest alliance of allies ever to align. Just check the description. San Fran Tokyo 2, if you're not quite industrial age or above, or let's say you're a low-level industrial, whatever, San Fran Tokyo 2 is a great place to join as well. We will help you learn the proper strategies as far as war attacks, you know, stuff like that. Basically, just join us, hang out, say what up. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.